I learned this in the last video, so I'm not going to ask for a latte when I go to... Yo, what is up, people? It's your boy, Peely9, and we're back with another, not a music video, but another, like, Italian lesson. I mean, this is easy Italian, learning Italian from the street. So this is 14 things you should never do in Italy. Before we get into this video, I want to thank you for rocking with the other one. Everyone had a good laugh with the white socks, and people are being really informative and supportive in the comment section. So thank you for that. We are almost at 10K also. So if you're watching my stuff, which is about 80% of you, and you're not subscribed, then make sure you subscribe. We're almost at 10K and support the journey. Let me know what else I should react to. Apart from music videos, there's loads of music videos that I need to get into. Let me know some informative videos like this one and some viral videos in Italy and stuff like that, so I can learn not just about the music culture, but other culture as well. This is 10 minutes long, so I'm going to get into it. But yeah, let's go.
Gli italiani sono tranquillissimi, però ci sono alcune regole sociali che prendono molto sul serio.
Se non vuoi essere riconosciuto come turista, ecco le 14 cose da evitare in Italia.
Ok, so it says if you don't want to be recognized as a tourist, is it a bad thing being recognized as a tourist? You know, there's like, it's fine being recognized as a tourist. No, if I go to Italy and you can tell that I'm English or not from Italy, I hope I'd be welcomed. I'm not going to be scared away from the country, am I? I'm not going to get people attacking me.
No. Ciao Luigi. Ciao.
Spesso si impara che ciao vuol dire hello.
Ciao.
Però in realtà questa è la versione informale e non è sempre adatta a tutte le situazioni. Per esempio, se entri in un bar o in un ristorante e non conosci i camerieri, sarebbe meglio usare la versione formale. Buongiorno di giorno e buonasera di sera.
Buongiorno and buonasera. That's too many hellos. So ciao means hello, buonasera means good evening, and buongiorno means good morning, I assume, or good afternoon. I'll probably just use ciao, and I'll try and use the other terms, but yeah. And it says say hi to everyone. If you've ever been to London and you've ever been on the tubes, especially in rush hour, no one speaks to each other. No one. There's not even eye contact. You look at someone in the eye and you know, not that there'd be a problem, but everyone's a bit hostile with it. And it's a shame. I wish everyone was a little bit more communicative. I'm making up words. But yeah. I feel like, though, when I do go on holiday in general, I've not been in Italy, but when I go to other places, I do say hello to a lot of people anyway, and a lot of the people that are from the country, because it's rude not to. I'm coming to your country, I'm embracing your culture, and I like to say thank you and hello, and yeah. And you want that to be reciprocated. You don't want tourists coming to your country and just being dicks, and it's just... Don't come to the country, you know what I mean? If you don't want to embrace in our culture and don't want to like our people, then why come? Anyways, 10-minute video. If I do this breakdown on every point, then we'll be here all day. So.
Ciao.
Un latte, per favore.
Bianco. Sì.
Latte.
Latte means milk, right? We learned that in the last video.
Latte.
Ciao.
E un caffè per favore.
No, un caffè normale?
Sì.
Okay. Latte.
Grazie.
Bianco. Ok.
Milk.
Caffè normale.
We learned this already, people. We learned this. You know, I learned this in the last video, so I'm not going to ask for a latte when I go to... I'll just ask for a Americano anyway. Oh, wait, you don't do them either. So I don't know. I'll just ask for a black coffee or just a coffee. Just give me a coffee. Just give me caffeine.
Perché è così piccolo?
And it's small because it's an espresso, right? And there's espresso is like a normal coffee in your country, whereas normal coffees over here is like a cup or whatever, and then large and... and a venti, which is like the biggest one, I think.
Dov'è il caffè?
In Italia, latte vuol dire milk. Quindi, se chiedi un latte al bar, riceverai una tazza di latte.
We got that one right,
per avere
people. We're
un
learning.
Latte con il caffè dentro, devi chiedere un latte macchiato.
Macchiato, we learn
per
that.
Il caffè,
yeah.
Invece, il caffè normale... Per noi è un caffè espresso molto corto e...
Strong and strong. See, we learning, people. Obviously, this is all from the last video, but, you know, I'm remembering, which is good. You can tell that I'm embracing the Italian culture.
Molto forte. Per avere un caffè lungo, devi chiedere un caffè americano.
Ciao. Un cappuccino, per favore.
A quest'ora? Ma non si può acquistare un cappuccino.
In Italia il cappuccino è visto come una cosa da colazione. Infatti gli italiani non prendono mai il cappuccino dopo mezzogiorno. Io una volta, 10 anni fa, conoscevo questa regola, ma volevo tanto un cappuccino. Quindi ho chiesto un cappuccino alle 3 e il cameriere mi ha riso in faccia.
Can I ask one thing? Are these people Italian or are they American speaking Italian or what? Because she said she knew the rule, but she still she still requested for a cappuccino anyway after 2 p.m. So yeah, it just let me know in the comment section down below. And also little segue, if you haven't seen last Friday, there's an Italian streamer called Flacco420 underscore, I do believe. And he actually interviewed me and we had a long chat on Discord and I was on his stream for about just under 2 hours. And it was a real good journey, real fun time. And we discussed music videos. We've done some reactions to some Guay Paquano's new stuff, I think. Or did we not? And a lady as well that raps. I can't remember her name. I'm sorry. And it was a real fun time. We'll probably do that again. So I hosted it on my Twitch. So if you missed that, make sure you go to twitch.tv/peely9. And next time that comes on, I'll be hosting it. So you'll be able to see the full show and the full stream. So yeah, make sure you follow me at twitch.tv/peely9 and turn on notifications. Let's go.
No, noi facciamo la nostra colazione all'italiana, è questa. Questa, sì. No. No, né uova né becco.
Tutto qui è buono, ma ho fame.
In Italia la colazione è una colazione dolce, sempre. E rispetto alle altre colazioni non è tanto abbondante. Di solito è un caffè o un cappuccino e una brioche dolce.
Parmigiano, per favore.
Bro, like, I fast anyway, but when I'm not fasting, I like to eat big meals and for breakfast and, like, full Englishes, which is a full English. Eggs, beans, hash browns. We even have chips, which fries. You know what I mean? We the English are a bit different. But I fast anyway, so I don't break fast now until gone midday. So I'm just drinking black coffee in the morning for breakfast anyway, or not for breakfast, but just when I wake up.
Parmigiano, parmigiano. No.
Let him have some cheese on his fish, the poor man.
No, parmigiano.
No parmigiano, no.
Quando si tratta di cibo, ci sono tanti abbinamenti proibiti.
Ma il peccato più grave che puoi fare agli occhi di un italiano è mettere formaggio.
I don't know anyone that puts cheese on a fish. I really do not know anyone, so it might be forbidden in the eyes of an Italian, but I just think it's forbidden in general.
Sul pesce.
Non si fa.
No.
A meno che non sia un ristorante super 5 stelle chic, in cui vogliono
ricettine,
fare una...
un po' così.
Sì,
no. That makes sense.
Infrangere le regole.
Di proposito.
Per essere fighi.
Pazzi.
Sì, ma non si fa in Italia.
No. Oh... Amici, cari amici, buonissimo.
Questi tedeschi non capiscono niente, prego. Secondo me.
Buonissimo. Perfetto.
Quando mangiamo...
So, like, I've always known you have, like, red wine with a steak, for example, or with your red meats, you have red wine. And a lot of people just like wine with their meals in general over here. Some people will have a beer even though it's bloating, like a lager. I just generally drink water with a meal. That's it, really. I don't really drink alcoholic beverages when I'm eating. I like to do that after.
Evitiamo sempre bevande dolci o troppo complesse come cocktail. Per esempio, non mangeremo mai accompagnati da uno spritz o da un prosecco molto dolce.
Oh, so you're saying you don't... Oh, okay, yeah, that makes fine. Yeah, that makes sense then. I was going to say, like, I don't know anyone that does that, but yeah, a wine or a beer, like I was just saying, yeah.
Mangiamo volentieri con un vino o una birra.
Acqua di rubinetto.
In Italia sì, si usa acqua in bottiglia della sorgente.
Per favore.
La posso portare.
L'acqua del rubinetto di solito non è disponibile.
Fair enough.
Infatti, quando lo chiedi, spesso ti dicono di no. Questo mi è successo più volte qua in Italia. Purtroppo bisogna comprare una bottiglia d'acqua confezionata.
Sperando che prima o poi Janusz riesca ad avere un po' di acqua del rubinetto, ma non sono proprio sicuro. Vi volevamo ricordare che abbiamo un Patreon.
Per avere un aiuto in più, per imparare un sacco di materiali.
Audio.
Per finire, un cappuccino.
You can't have a cappuccino.
Well, we've got the double bubble.
You can't even have cappuccino in the morning, so you can only have cappuccino in the morning, so you're not going to have one after a meal. Yeah, that doesn't make sense anyway, like... The rules aren't that strict. They're just common sense. So I don't think you Italianos are too extreme from what I'm seeing at the moment. Sorry about the adverts, but you know, fresh reactions.
Dopo i pasti prendiamo spessissimo il caffè. A volte normale espresso, a volte.
In the UK. Like, you get a desserts menu, and then, like, you can have your cheesecake, ice creams, brownie, whatever is on the menu, the dessert menu, the specials. But there's also, you get coffee. So you can have, like, your Irish coffee, which is, like, I think, like, Bailey's in a coffee and stuff. That makes sense. I mean... You're saying you have like something like a macchiato or espresso, but you won't have a cappuccino.
Latte macchiato con una goccia di latte, ma mai, mai un cappuccino. Troppo latte. Non siamo abituati a bere tutto quel liquido alla fine di un pasto. Il caffè è sempre molto corto, è quasi uno sciottino, che se macchiato non raggiunge mai un cappuccino come quantità. Bere un cappuccino sarebbe... stancante.
Per gli italiani il mangiare e il bere sono due cose sacre. Bisogna dedicare il giusto tempo e la giusta attenzione, spesso seduti con gli amici. Quindi è rarissimo vedere un italiano che mangia o beve mentre cammina in strada.
Ciao!
Wow, buonissimo!
Right, two things I've noticed. Obviously, I think they're going to say we never share a pizza. You order a pizza of yourself, which I think, I said in the last video, and everyone was like, you need to go to Naples. You need to try a real Italian pizza. I'm not the biggest fan of pizza. I eat them. I'm not a fussy eater at all, so I like them, but I'm not... there's other meals and other things that my taste buds prefer. But that being said, if I do order a pizza, it has to be for myself. I don't want to be sharing my meals. So I hope that's the path we're going down. And I like the fact that you say when you're having a coffee or something to eat, you don't do it whilst you're walking. It's something that you spend dedicated time to, which is really actually cool, like a cool way of building your community. And like, of course, over here, like, if I meet clients or work acquaintances or have a meeting, we can have it over coffee, which is cool. But I will grab a coffee on the move quite a lot of times where I'm active and have to be in certain places or whatever. So, yeah.
Grazie. Okay.
Per noi condividere la pizza è inconcepibile.
I mean, it's not chiedere a un italiano di condividere
la pizza è come chiedere a un inglese di condividere la birra. Condividere la pizza per noi è una sofferenza estrema, perché per noi avere una pizza e mangiarla tutta è come avere un obiettivo e arrivare alla fine di questo obiettivo. Non poter arrivare alla fine di questo obiettivo e tagliare questo traguardo è una sofferenza incredibile. Non fate questo ai vostri amici italiani. Un altro abbinamento proibito in Italia è...
This has been a hot topic at the moment. Another forbidden combination in Italy is pineapple on pizza. Me, again, I'm not a fussy eater. I would eat pineapple on a pizza. I have had it in the past, and it's called Hawaiian, which is ham and pineapple, and you can get that literally anywhere. You can get it from the supermarkets, you can get it from restaurants, where, you know, you can get it from wherever in the UK. And a lot of people on the internet are having this argument. It's not something I would order. It's not something that I would go out my way to have, but I don't think it's disgusting. So I'm not sitting on the fence on this one. I would have it, but I mean, it's not something that I want to have. I would go for something else.
L'ananas sulla pizza.
And in fact, I'm a really big fan of margherita if I do have a pizza. Like I say, don't eat it often, but if I do, margherita is fine, man.
Brr. Anche se in realtà, bisogna dirlo, alcuni ristoranti, alcune pizzerie in Italia iniziano a mettere l'ananas sulla pizza. Pazzi. Pazzi. No ketchup sulla pizza. Che c'è da dire?
You already got tomato sauce on it.
Ketchup sulla pizza? No. Dai.
Uno, due, tre. Woo!
Gli italiani sono maestri della moderazione. Non esiste il doppio espresso e quando bevono, di solito bevono per il gusto di farlo. Bevono spessissimo, anche un bicchiere di vino con ogni pasto, ma non si ubriacano quasi mai.
That's crazy, man. Don't you ever just want to let loose and just, you know, go all out and party and shit?
E quando ci salutiamo, che sia appena ci incontriamo o quando ci salutiamo per andare via, ci diamo spesso due baci. Il primo bacio è sempre nella stessa direzione.
That makes sense.
Bacia sulla guancia destra. Prima così, ci si lancia così e poi ci si bacia sulla sinistra. È da sapere perché potrebbe succedere l'irreparabile se vi lanciate entrambi nella stessa direzione.
Ovviamente ci siamo divertiti un po' con questo video e gli italiani sono molto simpatici anche se infrangi queste regole.
Nessun tedesco, polacco, cameriere o barista è stato maltrattato durante questi video.
Very good, very good.
Sporti per finire.
cappuccino.
Oh, he's German.
He's German.
Okay.
And she's Polish. I knew she was an Italian. I did ask. I think the main reason I asked was because of this lady, but she's, I don't know if she speaks good Italian or not, but she seemed to speak very slowly, and I thought, yeah. Very, very good. There's a couple of, it seems like they have a lot more videos on here, so I might have a look through their channel and see what's popular, and yeah, these are going to be long videos, but I hope you enjoyed them. If not, then I won't continue doing them, but let me know which ones I should react to next, and let me know what music videos and all that stuff I should react to next. Thank you everyone that's been on the journey so far. Like I said at the start of the video, I'm almost at 10,000 subs, and it's been such an amazing journey. So yeah, if you're following and you're not subscribed, then I would greatly appreciate it. I only need like 50, 60, 70 more subs. So. Yeah, we're almost there. I'm going to wrap it up because it's been a hell of a long video, but I hope you enjoyed this, and let me know what I should react to next. It's been your boy, Peely9, and I'm out.